folks. Ever since I was a little kid, I've been fascinated with a simple little rubber ball. I found that you could spend hours playing with it, and eventually you could learn to do really neat things like making it spin and move. You could make it roll, and you could make it look like it had a mind of its own. I thought it was fun. I played with it over and over again, spent hours and hours developing these wonderful skills, but eventually I learned that there's more to sleight of hand than skill. That kind of manipulative skill is not the same thing as sleight of hand, because in sleight of hand, you hide all that skill so that people can't see it, and you make magic. When you do that, it looks like the ball can disappear and then reappear, as if one hand doesn't know what the other is doing. You can take the ball and push it through one knee, and it comes out the other. Or you can take the ball and heat it up a little bit, and then push it right through the trousers and into the pocket. Now, with a ball here, we can split it into two balls, and they're both solid balls. You can take one of these balls, push it through this knee, it comes out that knee. I'll do it again. Going through one knee is easy, because I always keep another ball behind that knee. I mean, sometimes I keep it behind the knee. Sometimes I keep it over here in my pocket. It doesn't matter where you keep it as long as you know how to find it. And it's always good to have an extra ball when you need it. And that's the multiplying balls.